To continue Hogwarts Pride Week, we sorted 12-star cinema characters into a house that doesn't have the best reputation, but still able to produce one of the best and powerful wizards in the world of Harry Potter. Today's house is Slytherin. Slytherin values ambition, resourcefulness, cunning, determination, and cleverness. They are also strong leaders, confident, self-assured, and have the inclination to disregard rules. The house's founder, Salazar Slytherin, took in those with great ambition and cunning. With that, here are 12-star cinema characters that will fit right in with Slytherin.
Sandali, hindi ako sigurado dyan ha. I-check ko muna yung schedule ko. Busy ako this month eh. Marami kaming mga teachers, seminars. Hectic kami dito. I-check ko muna. Ay, nako, ito na. Oh, dumating na yung mga friends ko. Ngayon lang ako mag-unwind. Sige na. Ayun na, magpa-party pa kami. Sige, sige. Bye-bye, bye-bye. Yes, disculpa, disculpa. Lo siento, sir. Oh, yes, yes.
Let's start things off with the eldest Salazar sibling, Teddy from Four Sisters in a Wedding. Now, if you and I both watched the same film, Teddy exhibited a cunning and resourceful attitude throughout the film. From hiding what actually happened to her in Spain, to her plotting to ruin the Bayag's reputation, scream Slytherin.
This is Lyda McTellus version 2.0. Wiser. Braver. Stronger. Bolder. Fiercer.
Future monster.
Now you may be surprised why the ever cheerful Lyda McTellus from It Takes a Man and a Woman is in this list. Well, if you've seen her transformation in the film, she went from this flighty and ever dedicated girl to a fierce, ambitious, and determined queen who handed Miggy's ass to him with her clever quips.
Annoying.
If Lyda came as a surprise, I'm sure Miggy Montenegro won't surprise you. He and Lyda are practically the same. Ambitious, determined, confident, and resourceful.
Hindi kita titigilan ng katinitay na kapag-usap.
Lovely and intelligent Gab broke a lot of rules in her wish to end her and Dot's marriage in Can't Help Falling in Love. She did everything in her power to fix things, which showed her highly developed sense of self-preservation, another distinct trait of a Slytherin.
Operation! Babagsakin si Gio! Yeah!
Now hear me out on this one. Just like Gio's case in the Hufflepuff video, one might think Kali doesn't fit the Slytherin mold. But remember, just because you're in Slytherin doesn't mean you're the bad guy. Kali did exhibit traits of cunningness and resourcefulness throughout the film.
Oh my god! Nakakaloka! That was worse than a Chris Aquino horror movie experience. But I am okay.
It is a weird coincidence that a lot of the antagonists of the Harry Potter franchise came from Slytherin. So it's fitting that we include one in this video. It's none other than Rosel from Sister Rockas. She did redeem herself in the end, but her self-assured and cunning attitude makes her a perfect fit for Slytherin.
Try me.
Another characteristic that can be noticed from Slytherin students and alumni is they're a bit unhinged and brooding. It's a very fitting characteristic for Brian's unconventional character from The Unmarried Wife.
That person is just a name on my birth records. Who are you to force me to apologize to someone who does not deserve it? You're just a thief who stole my money!
In the words of Shine, Anghel nga yung mukha mo, halibaw naman yung ugali mo. Okay. So Luke from Loving in Tandem redeemed himself, but his angelic face belies a more self-preserving and determined attitude which will make him more than welcome in Slytherin.
I'm so G-R-R-R-R-R to the 100th power. May pa sorry-sorry pa siyang pa-undress you there in the hospital. I will not let him off the hook. Mark my word, I'm gonna make him suffer just the way I did.
Nothing describes Girly from Girl Boy Bakla Tomboy more perfectly is that her delirious level of self-confidence and self-assurance. Her determination to get back at Mark and her cunning way she slithered into Harry's arms makes her perfect for this serpentine house.
Akong bahala sa'yo. Basta ikaw bahala sa thesis ko ngayon darating na summer.
James from Vincent Kath and James can literally be a poster child for Slytherin. He's determined to get the girl, using resourceful methods of using his cousin as a bridge, and boasting lots of confidence due to his irresistible good looks.
Magdasal ka, Patricia.
Sister Alice from Eerie is literally a reincarnation of Snape. She's definitely shrewd and cunning. You never know what secrets hide behind that veil.
You are on fire!
Is this list really complete without Kimmy from Kimidora and the Temple of Kieme? She's Dolores Umbridge in a different body and even more chaotic. She literally embodies every characteristic of a Slytherin. From her strong leadership skills, self-assurance, cunning and cleverness, to her determination and definitely her disregard for rules. She might be the heir of Slytherin, y'all! Which of these Slytherin students is your favorite? Do you have other characters in mind you think belongs here? Share it in the comments. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And stay tuned for the last two houses for Hogwarts Pride Week. So, you better click that subscribe button and the bell button so you'll be notified of our next videos.